Today this is the special lecture. This is the compiler designing. In the compiler designing, we will solve some basic questions that will clear your concept. We will talk about the operator precedence. Okay. So let's we start. So what we have written already, we have studied the C programming language. In the C programming language, you have seen that precedence of operator of star, divide, and this is the modulo, and this is the divide, means you can say this is the remainder, divide, plus and minus. It has the greater precedence than the relational operator. What are the relational operator? Double equal, and this is not equal, and this is greater than, less than, greater than equal to, and less than equal to. So this has more precedence than this. Okay, then after that, this has more precedence than this this logical operator, and this is the AND, and this is the OR, and this is the NOT. Okay, so at first you have to think that what is this and what we are talking here, we are talking about this topic. Okay, let us, we will just solve one example. It will clear you whenever you have such type of any problem. You know that here one, he has written one is greater than equal to, then after that actually the problem is this, one is greater than 2 plus 3 and 4. Okay, how the computer will solve such type of problem? So at first the computer, it will take, okay, because there is a first operator is greater than, second operator is plus, third operator is AND. So which one will the computer will take at first? Okay, so in this condition you can see that here greater than, then plus, and this, at first you know that plus, it has greater precedence than other operator, relational operator or logical operator. You can see that this is the normal operator. Okay, so after then so at first we will calculate this one. Why? Because of it has more precedence. So this one greater than 3 plus 2 is equal to 5 and 4. Okay, so after then which one the computer will take at first? You can see there is a greater than symbol. Greater than symbol is here, and this is the logical operator, and logical operator is here. So the computer, it will take at first this one. So at first your computer, it will operate this one. So 1 and 5, it will be operate at first. You know that 1 is not greater than 5. It means that here 0, that is the outcome, or you can say that is the false. Okay, either 0 or false, you can think. Now and 4. 4 means true. Whenever you are using the logical operator, at that time if there is a 0, 0 means false, and if there is any value, that is true, means 1. Okay, so you know that in the logical operator 0 and 1, it means that this is the 0 and 1. You must note this number first, 1 and 1 is equal to 1 and 0 is equal to 0 and 1 is equal to 0 and 0 is equal to. Already you have solved such type of problem in your intermediate. Okay, so 1 and 1 means 1, 1 means true. Okay, this already we have done. Now after then, for the AND operator, both must be true, then your true, you will get the output true. Both must be true. If anyone is false in this condition, here 0, 0, 0. So in this condition, you know that there is a false, it means that your answer, it will be false. That is the way to calculate such type of problem in the computer science. Okay, so already we have discussed such type of problem. Okay, so now after then, so this is the precedence of operator in C language. Now after then, associativity of operator. Why we are just talking about this topic? In the grammar also, we are using the precedence of algorithm. Okay, we will discuss here how the computer it is working. So here after that we have written associativity of operator. Okay, so what is the associativity? In the mathematics, many people they have also used the this in the group. Group, the first one is the closure and second one is the associativity property. And third one is inverse and fourth is identity. So where we are using this such type of closure property, associative property, the inverse property, identity property, this is a question. Okay, so here already we have discussed where we are using the closure property, okay, in the previous video. Today we are talking about the associativity property. Where the associativity property we are using. So now you can see that here associativity operator we have written, if two operators have same precedence, if two operators have same precedence, then we use either left to right or right to left. It's depend on the problems. Okay, so actually what is left to right and what is right to left? Okay, you have also seen, if you are using the Yashwant Kanetkar book, okay, I also prefer to the students the Yashwant Kanetkar book. Okay, whenever you are using this, then you have also seen there is a left to right or right to left. What is the meaning of this? I have written there are three conditions, number conditions. First, this is the bracket, and after that we have used some different type of bracket, and we have used this is the left to right, and after that we have used here not operator, minus, plus, and after then plus plus and minus minus and this is the this is not and, this is the address operator, this is the pointer. Okay, then size of already you have used also, type operator also, and this is the conditional operator. This is just like this. Okay, this is the conditional operator. So such type of such type of operator you will use right to left. And at last we have written multiply, divide, this is a remainder, plus, minus, less than equal to, greater than equal to, less than, greater than equal to, this is greater than, this is greater than equal to, equal to, equal to, not equal to, and this is the end, and this is the exponential symbol, and this is the end, and this is the or. So all the operator we have written here, that is the left to right. So today we will discuss what is the left to right. Okay, so now here you can see that whenever you have such type of problem, I have used this problem 1 equal to and 2 and not equal to 3. Whenever the computer has such type of problem, 1 equal to 2 and not equal to 3, so then the computer it will check that if you have same operator or different type of operator, then it will check. Number first is equal to, okay. Number first is equal to and second is not equal to. And not equal to. You can see that both operator are in the third. Okay. And here we have written left to right. It means that whenever you have two operator and both have same precedence, then you will use left to right. So which one is the left? At first you will take this one, then you will take this one. This is the meaning of left to right or right to left. Okay, so you know that 1 equal to 2. So the computer it will check that 1 equal to 2. No, this is not equal to. So it means that your result it will be false. You know that 1 is not equal to 2. False means 0. Your answer is 0. Okay, then after then not equal to 3. Now he is asking 0 not equal to 3. You know that 0, it is not equal to 3. Yes, 0 is not equal to 3. Yes. It means that your result it will be yes means true. Your result is true in this condition. Okay. So 0 is not equal to 3. Okay. So now, so this is the meaning of in C language, the operator, how to you will use the operator. Okay. And if you are preparing for the your placement or for any exam, so such type of these all precedence of operator you have to remember. Okay, in the interview also they asked the simple type of question. So today we will use and we will discuss about the operator precedence in the compiler designing. So at first we are talking about operator grammar. What is the operator grammar? A grammar which is used to generate definite mathematics operation with some restrictions. Okay, that is the operator grammar. You have here, you can see that E, it is producing E plus E, or it is producing E star E, or it is producing I B. Okay, so this is the operator grammar. Why? And this is not operator grammar. Both are same. Both are same, but this is not this is operator grammar, because whenever two variables are each other, so it is not the operator grammar. You can see that this is also variable and this is also variable. Both are variable. In this condition, you will say that this is not the operator grammar. Okay. Now today we will discuss. Now we are coming on the our actual point. Why we have made this video, this lecture. Okay. So now today we will take this question, and we have taken that E is producing E plus E, or oblique it is producing E star E, oblique it is producing ID. So the algorithm I have written, by the help of this, you have, at first you have to make a chart. In this chart I have written all the identifier. Okay, the first one is ID, I have written here. The second one is plus, I have written here. Star, I have written here. And that's, at last we have written dollar. Same, all we have written here. Now the question is, what, how we have made this this chart? How we have written here greater than equal to or less than equal to? So the first one is, I have written ID and ID. Whenever we are operating two ID and ID operator, then after that we have written here blank symbol. What is the meaning of blank symbol? Here we have written three algorithm, number four algorithm actually. Okay, there are the four. Okay, four rules you can say. The first rules is, identifier will give the highest precedence. Whenever there is an identifier and you are relating the identifier with any other operator, then it has the highest precedence. So identifier, you are comparing ID and plus. So ID has highest precedence. So the symbol is this. It means that plus and ID greater is ID. Okay. Then after that, ID has highest precedence. ID has highest precedence. So it is greater than, it is greater than, it is greater than. Means ID is greater than all plus star and dollar. And also, and ID and ID, both will be blank. Okay. You have to also remember, I have not written here. If you are operating ID and ID in this condition, it will be blank. Second, now you can see again, you know that ID has higher precedence, so ID and plus, that will be less than, and ID is greater than. Okay. Again, now you have plus and plus. Okay. Why we were discussing about this? After that we have written plus and plus. Now you can see that plus is here. Okay. Whenever you are using the plus, and we have written left to right associative. We have used the associativity property. Why we are discussing about the associativity property? The question is, if you will ask this question to anyone, 3 minus 3 minus 3, then the computer, how he will calculate? Maybe he will take the first one is this, 3 minus 3 minus 3. In this condition, 3 minus 3 is 0, minus 3 is equal to minus 3. If the computer, it will take this one first, in this condition, 3 minus 3 minus 3, then your answer is 3 minus 0 is equal to 3. And you know that both are not equal. Minus 3 is not equal to 3. You can see that. So which one the computer it will take first? This is the question. If you are asking this question, 3 minus 3 minus 3, so what will be the answer? So I have written here associativity property. Associativity property means whenever you have two same symbol, then you will use left to right. Already we have written here star, divide, and this is remainder, plus minus. Whenever you have, then you have to use left to right. Okay, left to right. So your computer, it will see that this is minus and this is minus. So at first your left it will be calculated, then your right will be calculated. So this is your correct answer. This is not correct answer. Okay, now So the meaning of associativity property we are using in our computer science. And the second one is, here also you can see that you have plus and plus. Okay, both have the same operator, both are same operator. Okay, I have written here, plus is greater than plus because of left associativity. Okay, because of left associativity means whenever you have same operator, then at first you have to calculate the left one. You can see that here 3 minus 3 minus 3, at first we have calculated this one, then we calculated this one. Okay, it means that it has more precedence than this. Okay, so we have written here plus is greater than plus, so we have written here plus is greater than plus, very very simple. Okay, then after that we are calculating plus and star. Already you know that star is greater than plus. Okay, already we have discussed here star, it has more precedence, and we have also written the order. At first you will board mass, at first you will take star, then you will take this one, this. Okay, you will use the board mass. Okay, and you can also check it. So star has more precedence than this, so plus is less than star, then after then plus is greater than dollar. I have written here dollar will have the least precedence compared with other operator. Okay, so this is the dollar. Whenever you are comparing dollar and plus, so it has the least. So after then I have written this is less than, this is less than, this is less than, and dollar, same as blank. And ID, it has blank, you have to remember it whenever you are making this chart. Now after that, you know that star has more precedence, ID has more precedence than any operator. This is the first algorithm, in the first algorithm we have written. So this is less, ID has greater than, but star has more precedence than other. So star is greater than plus, star is greater, star and star. Why we have used star and star? Again, I have told you that left associativity. Whenever you are using star and star, you know that here 3 minus 3 minus 3. At first you will calculate this one, 3 minus 3. Then you will calculate this one. So according to this, it means that this one has higher precedence than this. So this one has higher precedence than this. Left associativity, we are using the left associativity, so star is greater than star. Okay, then after then star, this star has greater precedence than this. Now at last I have written dollar has least precedence than other operator, so dollar, that is less than, and this is the blank. Okay, this is the way to draw, to make your chart. Now by the help of this chart I will just solve some relational, some tables. Okay, now we will discuss. So now I will make the parser tree. Okay, we have written two examples. The first example, that is ID plus ID star ID and dollar, I have written. Okay, so this one is, this example we have taken from here. This is ID plus ID oblique, okay, then ID star ID, okay, then otherwise dollar. Okay, so at first I have written here whenever you have less than, then you will push, whenever you have greater than, then you will pop. Okay, here we have written something. Now operator precedence parser, so you will use the stack. In the stack, at first you will put here dollar. Okay, after that I have written something. Whenever the top of the stack is less than or equal to, then look ahead in the table, then we are going to push it, otherwise pop it. That meaning whenever you will get such symbol, then you will push it, whenever this symbol, then you will pop it. Okay, what is the meaning of this? Now the first one is this is your, this is your this table I am making here. Okay, I am making here. At first you have dollar. Okay, at first you have dollar. Okay, then your first symbol is ID. So you will compare ID and dollar. Your pointer is here. Okay, your pointer is here. And another quantity is here. Another quantity is here. So at first you are calculating this dollar and ID. Okay, at first this one. Dollar and ID. Now check here. Dollar and ID. This symbol. Dollar and ID, this symbol. So whenever you have such symbol, you will push. So you will push, it implies that push. Which one will push? ID will push. So ID will be push. And your pointer is here. Now your pointer is here. Okay. And next time your pointer is here. Now. Okay. Now the second time, at first you will compare this and this, not this and this. Okay. So ID and plus. ID and plus. Now you will check in the here. ID and plus. ID and plus. ID and plus. So this symbol, and this symbol means pop. It implies that pop. You have to pop it. Okay. So you have to pop it. Your pointer, it has come again here. Okay. Again it has come here. So whenever you are popping, then after that you have to write something here. Okay. After that we will discuss. So now your pointer is here. Now your pointer this, and you know that already we have discussed with plus. Okay, pointer is here and this dollar. Now third one is dollar and plus. It was this. Okay. Now dollar and plus. Now see here. Dollar and plus. Again pop. Sorry, push. Because of less than. Less than means push. Which one will push? Your plus, it will push. Okay. Your plus, it will push. Okay. So your pointer, it will come here. Your pointer, it will come here. Okay. Now next time it has pushed, it means that your pointer, it will come here. Okay. Your pointer, it has come here now. Now you will calculate this plus and this ID. Now fourth time, this plus and this is ID. This plus and this is ID. So now you will check here. Plus and ID. Plus and ID, then you have less than. Less than, I have written less than. What is the meaning of less than? Less than means push. It implies that again you will push. And push means your ID, it will be pushed. It means that your ID, it will push and your pointer, it will come here. Okay. Your pointer is here now. And again, next pointer, it will come here. Okay. Already because we have pushed this ID. Now. Now we will compare this star and ID. Okay. We will come, sorry, ID and star. Fifth time, we will compare ID and star. Okay. ID and star. So you will come here. ID is here and star is here. So ID, you know that if you have this greater than symbol, whenever you have greater symbol, then you have to use pop. It means that you will pop. Okay. So pop means it has popped. Okay. Whenever you will pop, then after then you have to write something here. Okay. Now you have popped it. Now you will compare. Your pointer is here now. Your pointer is here. Now you will discuss with this point plus and your pointer is here. So now the sixth time you will compare plus and dollar star. You will compare plus and star. Plus is here and star is here. Now see there. Plus and star. It means that you are getting less than. Whenever you have less than symbol, you will push. It means that this time you will push. Which one will push? Your star, it will be pushed. It means that your star, it has come here. Okay. So whenever your star, it has come here, now your pointer, it will also come here. Okay. So, now you will compare your star and again, it has pushed. Okay. So your pointer, it will come here. Now, this star and ID. We will compare this star and ID. This star and ID. Okay. Now see here your star and ID. This is less than. This is less than. And for the less than we have written here this is push. So this is push. Okay. Very very simple. So you have to push. Which one will push? Star and ID. So your ID it will push. ID it will push. Your pointer it has come here. Okay, and next pointer it has come here. Very very simple. Okay, because ID it has this is the stack. you are pushing and popping. Okay, now the eighth time you will compare this quantities here ID. At first you have to write this one, then you have to write this one star. Okay, ID and star. Now you can see that ID and dollar. It means that you have greater symbol. Whenever you have greater symbol, it implies that you will pop. Okay, you will pop it. Now it means that ID will pop. So ID will pop. It implies that you are getting this. You have popped. So your pointer it has come here. Okay, your pointer it has come here. Now, but the star symbol, you know that the next pointer is here. Now you will compare 9, this star and dollar, star and dollar. Okay, star and dollar. Now you can see that star and dollar again greater than symbol. Whenever you have greater than symbol, it implies that again pop. So which one will pop? This will pop. So it means that this pop, it means that again this, very very simple. Okay, so your next pointer it has come here. Now very very simple. Now again 10th time you have to compare this plus, because pointer is here and one pointer is here. At first you have to write this one plus and this dollar, plus and this dollar, then plus and dollar again, plus and dollar. You can see that again we have to pop, because this is greater than, again we have to pop. Okay, so pop means your star, it will be pop. Now it has cut and this both match. Okay, so this is your parsing. Okay, this is your parsing technology. Okay, by the help of this parsing you have written bottom to top. Okay, top to down or bottom to top, we are talking about the top down parsing. And okay, so this and the next, when you popped, then your pointer it has come here. Then dollar and dollar, whenever you have dollar and dollar, dollar dollar means blank. It means that whenever you are comparing dollar dollar, it means blank, yani ki grammar acceptive, grammar acceptive. Very very simple. Okay, very very simple. Suppose you have any problem, again we have written another problem also. Okay, if you have any doubt in this question, again we will discuss. The next question is, suppose same question. Okay, because there is also plus and star. Okay, so this table we can also use the same technique for this problem also. There is no star, no problem. We have only plus and dollar. Okay, so no problem. Identify plus and dollar. There is no star. If there is no star, no problem. We can also draw the same problem. Okay, so now you can see that again at first you will write here dollar. Okay, and you have the first identified, that is that your pointer is here and your pointer is here. Okay, at first you will compare dollar and ID. First one is dollar and ID. Now check here, dollar and ID, less than means push, it implies that push. Which one will push? ID will push. ID is pushed. Okay, very very simple. Now the your pointer is here, pointer is here. Okay, after then ID is pushed. Okay, so your pointer it will come here, because already it has pushed. Now you will compare second time plus, at first you have to write this one, ID and plus, it means that you have to pop it. Now you have to pop it, pop. Okay, we popped it and E it has come here. Okay, now after then your pointer it has popped. Okay, your pointer it has come here. Okay, so now you will compare third, your this dollar and plus. You will compare this dollar and plus, dollar, okay, and plus. So your dollar, now you check here, dollar and plus, dollar and plus, you have less than symbol. Less than symbol means you will push. Again you will push. Which one will push? Your plus, it will push. So your plus, it has come here. Your pointer, it has come here. Okay. Then your plus and now next pointer, it is here. Next pointer is here. Now you will compare plus and ID. Now you will compare plus and ID. Plus is here. Okay. So fourth time. Now you will check here plus and ID. Plus and ID. Less than, it implies that. Again push. It implies that. Push. Okay. Which one will push? Your ID, it will push here. Your ID, it has come here. Your pointer, it has come here. Okay. So next time, ID we have pushed it. So your pointer, it will come here. Now you will compare ID and plus. Now you will compare ID and plus. So now check here, ID and plus. ID and plus, you have pushed. Because of you have this symbol, it implies that pop it. Sorry, you will pop it. Okay, so pop means your plus, it will come out. Okay, pop. Now you have to pop, sorry. It will come out. So this. Okay, so your pointer now, it is here. Okay, your pointer is here. Now you will compare six time. This plus and this plus. Whenever you have plus plus, you are comparing plus plus, you can see. So you have again pop it because of left associative. This is again pop. Pop means this. Okay, we popped it. Okay, so your pointer, it has also popped. So you are now here. Your pointer is here. Okay, so now you will compare seventh time. This is dollar and this is plus. Now you are comparing dollar and plus. Dollar and plus. So you have less than. Whenever you have less than, you will push it. Push it. Okay. Push means you have to push this plus here. Now your plus, it will come here and pointer, it will come here. Okay. Very simple. Now you will compare your pointer, it will come here. Now you will compare this plus and ID. Eighth, you will compare this plus and your ID. This is your ID. So this is plus and ID. You can see again you have less than. Again you have less than, it implies that you will again push. Again you will push, it implies that again you have to push. Which one you will push? Your ID, it will come here. Okay, your ID, it will come here. Now next pointer, it is here. Next pointer is here. Now ninth. Now you will compare ID and ID, you have pushed it, now you are here. Okay, next pointer is this. Now ID and plus. ID and plus, ID and plus. Now, ID and dollar. Sorry, ID and dollar. ID and dollar. Now, ID and dollar. You have pop this one because of this. You have to pop. Okay. So if you pop, so it will come out again. This is E. Okay. Now again, ninth, tenth. So your pointer is here. Your pointer is here again. Plus and dollar, plus and dollar. Now check plus and dollar. Plus and dollar. Again pop. Again pop. This is pop. Okay, pop means it has come outside. Okay, so now this time this and this. Okay, this is your answer. Because of this, again you pop, then after then dollar and dollar. Whenever you have dollar and dollar, and at that time your grammar, it has accepted. I think that you understand. Okay, so this is the way to parse. Okay, whatever they have given you the grammar. Okay, this is the method. Now we will discuss how to make your relation table. Okay, relation table already we have discussed. Okay, so now the second topic is we will discuss to find the longest functional table. We will discuss about the functional table. Okay, so I am erasing it, this one. Okay, this one I am erasing it, and then now I will construct the. So if you are just have any problem, then you can pause the video and after then you can again look it. Okay, so now we are making this, you have this problem, okay? We have this problem, we are talking about this problem. So, The first one is you have id. The first one you have id. Then after then you have plus. Then after then sorry you have plus. Then after then you have star. Then after then you have dollar. Then also here also you have id. This is plus. This is star and this is dollar. Okay. Then after that we have to draw the node. This is the first node, second node, third node, fourth node. And this is the first node, second node, third node, fourth node. Okay. Now you have to check. You are going. Okay. Now you can see that here one symbol. It means you are going from here to here. It means you are coming from here to here. Okay. Now we are drawing a graph. Okay. Now ID and ID, nothing. Then now id and plus, whenever you have, now suppose this is f, this is a function of f and this is a function of g. We are thinking this is a function of f and this is a function of g. Okay, so means f id, this is f plus, f star, f dollar, g id, this is g plus, g star, g dollar. Okay, so now this is a f and this is a g. Okay, now id and plus, now you can see that there is a nothing. Then id and plus, there is a symbol, means you are going from f to, you are going from f to g plus, you are going from f to g plus, f id to, sorry, f id to g plus, f id to g plus. The first one, first root is this. Second is you are going FID to G star. This is G star. This is G. FID to G star. FID to G star. FID to G star. Okay. Then you are going FID to G star. FID to G dollar. FID to G dollar. FID to G dollar. So you have three. Only three roots. Okay. Now, then second time. Now you have f plus to you are coming g star g g id to f plus g id to f plus g id to f plus g id to f plus. At first you are coming g id to f plus g id to f plus sorry g id to f plus then you are coming you are going f plus to g, g plus. This symbol means going, this symbol means coming. Okay. So f plus to g, f plus to g plus, 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 f plus to g plus. Then f plus to, sorry, g star to f plus, 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 g star to f plus. Okay, then g star to f plus, then f plus to g dollar, f plus to g dollar, f plus to, f plus to g dollar, f plus to g dollar. Okay, this one also calculated. Now this f star, GID to GID to F star, GID to F star, GID to F star. This is the first one. Then GID to F star. Then F star to F star to G plus, 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 F star to G plus. Okay. Okay, now f star to g plus. Okay, now f star to g star, f star to g star. Okay, f star to g star, g star, f star to g star. Okay, so this is f star to g star. Now f star to g star, then f star to g dollar, f star to g dollar, f star to g dollar. Okay, so okay, f star to g dollar. This, now this is dollar. Okay, very simple. Now the last one is F dollar, all are less than, means F dollar, G ID to F, F dollar, G ID to F dollar, G ID to F dollar, this is the first one. Then after then, G plus 2 F dollar, sorry, F dollar, G plus 2 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 F dollar, then G star to F dollar, then G star to F dollar, G star to F dollar. So this is the table, okay. So now operator functional table. Now we have to draw the maximum path. Okay, which one is the maximum path? How to find the maximum path? Now I am drawing something. After that I will explain to reduce the time, because I don't want to waste my time. I have written something here. So this is the first of ID. Then after then we have written this G star. Then after that we have written this F plus. Then after then we G plus. Then F dollar. Then after then we have written this is F dollar. Then after then we have written G plus. Then this is F dollar. Okay, this is G dollar. Okay, then the next one we have written here G ID. Okay, I will use another color. G ID, G ID. Okay, then we have written F star. Then we have written G dollar. Then we have written G plus. Then we have written F dollar. Then we have written G star. Then we have written F plus. Then we have written G plus. Then we have written F dollar. I will just explain you what is this. This is F plus. Then G plus. Then this is F dollar. Okay. So now I have written here the maximum, the first one I will explain. FID, from FID I will check, from FID you have three options. Number first, FID to G plus, FID to G plus, then FID to G, FID to G star, FID to G star, G star. You have three route from FID to either go to this route plus G plus, either go to FID to G star, and either FID to dollar, F dollar. So whenever you are reaching dollar, it means that this is your the end point. So that is cancel. Okay. Now from G plus, now we will check G plus. This is the G plus. This is G plus. From G plus, you have only one route to go. Only one route. Okay. Means from, it is coming from here to here. It is also coming from here to here. It is also coming from here to here. But there is only one route to go from G plus to F dollar. Only one route. Means you can go from here to another route. There is only one route. So that is only one route, that is also end. Okay, finish. Very very simple. Now G star, now you have G star, G star. From G star you have one route, that is you are coming, and second route you are coming from here, the second route you are going, means G star to F plus, G star to F plus. Okay, and the next route you have only one, you have to go to dollar, means G star to F dollar. So G star to F dollar, so it has also end point. Okay, now F plus, now you have come here F plus. So which one is F plus is there? From F plus you have, this is you are coming, you are going, yeah. From F plus to G plus, F plus to G plus, and you are coming, okay, you are going, okay. There is also two route. One route is also this, from F plus you are also going to G dollar. So this is also end point. Okay, this is also end point. Finish. Okay, so now after then, from F plus to G plus, now G plus, already we have discussed, from G plus already we have written here G plus to F, this is only one route, that is also end point. So the maximum length from here to here is This is the maximum length from here to here. Okay, this is the maximum root. That is the maximum root. Okay, now second, now the second one is GID. Okay, now after that I have written it. This is the GID. In GID, from GID, you can see that there is only one root, that is F plus, then after that everything we have written same thing, and this is the maximum root. Again, I want to just reduce the time. Okay, so this is the maximum root. Similarly, you can also find it. Okay, see, this is the maximum root. By the help of this maximum length, I am drawing one table. That table, it will clear actually what I want to teach you. So after that, I have written here something. After that, I have written here F and G. Okay, okay. So then we have written here, this is ID and this is plus, this is star and this is dot. Okay. Then after then we have written, this is 4, this is 2, this is 4, this is 0. Okay. And after then we have written, this is 5, this is 1, this is 3 and this is 0. Now what is this? By the help of this maximum table, I have written FID. FID, it has max length, that is 4. This is 1, this is 1, means 1H, 2H, 3H, 4H. Okay, max length is 4, FID. Then after that I have written F plus. From FID to this end point, the S, total number of edge is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now F plus, from F plus, now you will see only this one. From F plus, the max length is 1, 2, only 2 edges, and after then we can reach the end point, so that is 2. So we have written here 2. Okay, after then for F, we have written F star, we have written 4. Now you can see that F star, where is F star? We have to check. Where is F star? Where is here is F star. Now you will see that 1H, 2H, 3H, 4H. So there are total number of this length is 4. So we have written that is the 4, that is the meaning of 4. And whenever you are calculating this, that is the end point, you will write in here 0. Okay. Then after then we have written here GID. So from GID to this point, that is the end point, the total, the length is 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So this is the longest route reaching from here to here, that is 5. Okay. Then after then we have written G plus. You can see that G plus, where is G plus? Yeah, that is G plus to this only 1. So we have written here 1. Then after then we have written G star. G star is equal to 3. G star 1, 2, 3. Only 3. So we have written here, and at last we have written 0. What is the meaning of this? This is the question. We have made this functional table. Okay. So what is the meaning of this? Now, whenever you are calculating, we are discussing about the operator precedence. Okay. In the last table, in this table, you can see that whenever you are writing all the symbols, so this is a matrix. So matrix, its total order is order of n square, means time complexity is very far. Whenever there are many such type of symbols, and this is n into n matrix, then in this condition, your grammar, it will take total, the time complexity, it will be order of n square. But here you can see that the time complexity, there is only two row. Okay, so in this condition, its time complexity is 2 into n, because there is only one row, and second row, in one row n element, in second row n element, so its total element is total time complexity is 2n. Okay, so this is very small number first. Second, what is the meaning of this? Why we are teaching you? This is the question. We were talking about the operator precedence. You have seen also, at first we talk about this, then after that we talk about associative property, then after that we talk about this. By the help of this, we have solved some problem. We have also used this, by the help of this, we have done this task. After then, by the help of this task, we have done this, then we have done this task. Now we are calculating plus and plus. Suppose we are calculating plus and plus. Okay. So I am writing here, the problem was plus plus star star. Okay. I am writing here F plus G plus.
F star G star. So whenever you are taking plus plus, okay, minus minus, star star, I was talking about this 3 minus 3 minus 3. How the computer it will solve this problem? 3 minus 3 minus 3. He has used the left associative. He has used this one. At first he will take, he will solve this one. Then after whatever you have got, then it will solve this one. Already we have discussed. So whenever you have the same operator, then you are using this one. Left to right associative or right to left associative. Now you can check here by the help of this table. G plus and G, F plus and G plus. Now see that F plus is equal to 2. You can see that F plus is equal to 2. This is 2. This is 2. This is 2. Okay. And G plus. And G plus, this is 1. And this is 1. You know that 2 is greater than 1. 2 is greater than 1. So you can see also 2 is greater than 1 means if whenever you have both same precedence, then you have to use this one. You can see that you have to use this one. Already we were talking about this one. Whenever you have same operator, then you have to use left associative. Here also we were talking about the same thing. After that we have used this algorithm here, and after that by the huge calculation and algorithm we have draw one functional this table. By the help of this table we have got 2 is greater than 1. So now the second one, F star, you can see that F star is 4, F star is 4, and G star that is 3, and you know that 4 is greater than 3, okay, you have 4 is greater than 3, and if 4 is greater than 3, and again we have written here, whenever you have same operator, and this is a star, for this star you will use this operator, okay, and same thing also we have got. So by the help of this table, okay, we have also got all the operator precedence. Okay, we have got by the help of this table, we have got the operator precedence. So the application of this such we are reducing the time, its total complexity is only order of 2n. Okay, and the before we were talking about the relational table, that is the relational table. Okay, so this is the relational table. For the relational table, your time complexity is order of n square, but for this functional table, your time complexity is only order of 2n. Okay, your time complexity is order of 2n. You have to remember it. Okay, so there are some applications we have discussed. Advantage, functional table has lesser size compared to relational table. You can see that it has size is very less and its size is very big. Okay, the first advantage. Okay, in computer science, our motto, whenever you are writing any algorithm, your algorithm, it must be less space and it must be also less time. Okay, if you are writing any algorithm and it is taking more time to execute, it means that you are not a coder. You have to remember it. Okay, so we have written this one. The advantage is its lesser size. Okay, and whenever you are comparing ID and ID, can compare in functional table but is not in a relational table. Okay, ID and ID can be compared in functional table but not in relational table. Okay, you can see ID and ID can compare in functional table. You can see that FID and GID, you can compare here. FID and GID, you can compare, but in relational table you can see that there is nothing, it is blank. Okay, so that is the drawback of this this table. By the help of this table we can also compare. Okay, but there is also disadvantage. Whenever you have dollar, then there is nothing. Okay. Okay, then non blank entries in relational table. Okay, then after then also the other disadvantages, there is also blank. You can see that there is a blank. Okay, there is no blank, nothing. You have entered something, you have written. Okay, so maybe I can also give you any example. By the help of example, there are many blank. Okay, whenever you have blank, it means that you have left the you have taken the matrix, but you have not written something there, it means that you are occupying more space. Okay, so it will also take time, okay, to execute. So blank entries, it means that error. Okay, so error detecting capabilities of the functional table is less than error detecting capabilities of the relational table. Okay, so you have to remember this is the advantage and disadvantage of this this and this. I think that you understand everything. I tried to explain what we are what my motto to teach you, and this is the best lecture to just gain in compiler design. Okay, the operator precedence. Okay, thank you so much.